Hello guys, welcome to another second video. In this video we will see how to do linear regression using sklearn library. In the last video we seen how to do via statistics method. In this video we will see using library, and I will introduce some new things also in this video, like our custom train test split function and our custom label encoder also. First, I am imported the basic libraries NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib, like as I did in the last video. Same thing. I am running this cell. It's loading. Libraries are loading, so it will take some time in the first time. Now again, I am taking the salary dataset as I taken in the last video. Just run this cell. So in this video I am going to take more than one independent variable. Now here I am going to take all variables, like here y is years of experience and x is from salary to type, like in the age, company change, type. I will consider these variables also. See some info of our dataset. These are some statistics like mean, standard deviation. We have total 30 examples in the dataset. Finally, we don't have any null values, so we can easily proceed to further. Let's see some correlations. These are the correlations. These all things already we did in the last video, so I am not again retyping those things. Now we'll create our own label encoder. Like actually I made this thing, but that is not efficient with big data sets. Just I am giving some idea how that label encoder works. Let's create that one. Create class label encoder. I'm keeping capital E. I'm created a class called label encoder. In that class I'm defining a definition. That is VF fit transform. Self comma data. Here in the fit transform method I will pass the data. Let's take the data and convert into list to another duplicate list. I am creating one duplicate list. Equal to list data. This data here now let's see, we're taking the data and we have to separate the unique queue values. Like I'm creating another unique queue list, unique queue equal to list set data. So it takes the data and it if any common things are there, means it will remove those things and it will create a unique list. Like here, why we are doing this label encoding, means here in our data set where there is a type attribute is there. In that attribute there is a junior, middle and super senior, senior, all those things there. We have to convert those things into numbers. So actually our algorithms won't work with unstructured data like texting part like that. Next, I am returning the length also. I am taking the length of the unique queue list and I am creating a numbers from range 0 to that length of like number of unique queue items are there in that attribute. Numbers equal to list range 0 comma L. Now we have to replace that text data with this unique queue numbers. For I in range length of data, first we have to retrieve the indices of the unique queue number. Like if in our data there is a junior, like junior assigns to one number. We have to replace that with which number we assigned to that junior. In indices equal to unique dot index duplicate list inside I. Here we are taking the indices, means that we are assigning that indices, that index to the our junior value. Duplicate list I equal to that numbers in that index. So we are assigning that junior, we are assigning the some unique numbers to the junior. Like here, for example, if we take 4 0 1 2 3, like 0 is junior and 1 is middle and 2 is super senior, like 4 is senior, like that. Finally, we have to make our, again we have to reform the data set. Data equal to pd dot, like not reforming exactly, we are again we are return the our, we have to return the attribute which we are changing. What attribute we are changing, that we have to convert to data frame and we have to pass that attribute to the original data set. Pd dot data frame duplicate list return data. So we actually done with label encoder. First we have to check this label encoder, it is working or not. Encoder equal to label encoder data type, we have to change the type attribute to encoding. Encoder dot fit transform, I'm passing again that same attribute type. So it successfully it is working. Now let's see our data set. Data dot head. See our this type variable is changed to unique queue numbers. So we can pass this data set into our algorithms easily by changing those things. There is another things also there. I will like there is another methods of our encoding these things also there. I will show those things in the neural networks in that series. So next let's see how many unique queue values are there in our type. Data dot unique queue. See, we have 4 unique queue values in the type. One is junior, one is senior, one is super senior, one is middle. Now create our own custom train split function. Yep. Train test split. Here we have to pass the x comma y comma and the test size. First we have to shuffle, when we are taking the data set, first we have to shuffle the data set. So so our model won't, in some cases if we don't shuffle our data set, it undergoes to war fit, our model undergoes to war fit. So we have to shuffle before passing our data into model. Shuffle index for whole set equal to np dot random dot permutation length of x. I'm taking the length of x, like for example if I have trained 30 examples, right? In our data set we have 30 samples. So here takes the 30 number and creates a list from 0 to 29 and it shuffles the number, shuffles the data set. It shuffles the number contains from 0 to 29. Then we have to assign these indices to our original data set. X comma y equal to x shuffle index poll, comma y shuffle index poll. Now we have to separate our test size and train test data set and training data set. First I am going to take the length x length equal to length of x. Similarly we can take y length also, but here it's enough for taking only one length because both are its same proportion. So next thing is we have to create a training set. Training set equal to int x length into test size. If we have test size of we have to separate from 1 minus. For example, if we pass the 0.3 as a test size, and that means 30% of the data goes into test set and remaining 70% of the data goes to training set. See, here I am multiplying the x length into 1 minus test size. For example, if you take 0.3 as a test size, it means 1 minus 0.3, so it is 0.7. so x length into 0.7 means 70% of the data, and we are rounding that data by using int data type. Now let's create our x train, y train, those things. X train, x test, y train, comma y test equal to x training set comma x test training set all. Similarly y also, training set comma training set. Finally we have convert these things into numpy arrays, and we have to return those things. Return np dot array x train comma np dot array sorry np np dot array x test. Similarly np dot array y train comma np dot array y test. So we created the train test split function. Now let's check our train test split function, it is working or not. First I am taking a variable called x and np dot array data dot drop. Here I am dropping years of experience. Years experience, it is in the axis 1 equal to 1. Y equal to np dot array data years of experience. Now we have to pass our data set into train test split function. I'm copying this thing equal to train test split x comma y comma 0.3. Now let's run our, so it is successfully working. Let's check the result. X train, so we have length of x train, we have 21 examples in our training set and remaining 9 examples in our testing set. So we have chosen the 0.3 as a testing set, 30% for testing set. Now let's see length for x test. See, here we got 9 examples for testing set. Now let's see for similarly for y train, sorry not length, we already checked the thing. See, we have individual years of experience. In the next thing, we have to import the linear regression model, and we have to pass the data set into that model, and finally we have to predict. From sklearn dot linear model import linear regression model equal to linear regression x comma y. Sorry, here we don't want, like here no need to pass anything. Model dot fit x comma y. Here we fitted our model, then finally we have to predict our test data. Ypredict equal to model dot predict x test. Now let's see some accuracy, all those things. Finally we have to check the errors, like a mean squared error, mean absolute error, root mean square error and explained variance score. In the next video I will make a video on this separate video on this metrics, like how to create this metrics from scratch, all those things. In the next video we will see that thing. So here I imported this all those metrics, and here I am passing the y test and y predictions to that metrics, and it will say the how much our error is, like that. First we have to run this, our mean squared error is 0.17 and root mean squared error is 0.4172, and here mean absolute error is 0.36, and here accuracy we got 98%. In the last video we got 96%. In that case we considered only one independent variable, but in the case we increased our independent variable, so we can increase the data set. But again, if we shuffle the data set again, let's see this thing. Again our accuracy is reduced to 93%, because when you are shuffling the data set in some, like that depends upon the data set, how we are shuffling. Like sometimes it shuffles well and sometimes it not shuffle well, like that. If we use any seed in that shuffling, so if we again we rerun our shell, means it will give same shuffling order. There is a method also there by keeping the random.seed. Okay, thank you guys. I hope you like this video. In the next video, we will see how to create these metrics from scratch and what's going on exactly in that metrics. I will show in the next video. In that, after next video, I will create a linear regression by using normal equation. So what is in that video, I will explain what is the normal equation and why it is famous, and what are the drawbacks and what are the advantages for that by using that process. Okay, thank you guys. I hope you like this video. Thank you guys. I will see you in the next video.